My name is Tony Pan. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Modern Electron. First thing to understand about the energy sector is it is humongous. So it's several trillion dollars. It provides the lifeblood that runs everything in modern civilization. And this spans everything from generating electricity to transportation to creating industrial goods. Energy, because it's so big with a lot of heavy infrastructure, has tended to be a very slow-moving sector. However, that trend is changing recently with the advent of new renewables such as wind and solar, and also things like electric vehicles. If you think about how people run their everyday lives, a lot of the technology and energy that is used to power human civilization, it is literally centuries old. I took a plane ride to come to Dubai, and on that plane, there is something called a jet turbine. So that has giant spinning fan blades operating at insane temperatures. And just like cars and planes, it turns out in electricity, almost all electricity is generated using mechanical engines as well. It doesn't really matter whether you're starting out from old fuel sources such as coal, or you're using natural gas, which is cheaper and more abundant nowadays with more hydraulic fracturing. Or you can start with much newer and fancier technologies such as nuclear. You also have liquid hydrocarbons such as oil and diesel fuel. And you even have new technologies and sources such as solar thermal. But at the end of the day, no matter what that fuel source is, most of them are used to generate heat. So you can burn coal, burn natural gas, nuclear fuel, you're essentially burning through your nuclear reaction as well. But the end product is heat, and then you use that heat to boil water, and that water generates steam and turns that big fan. So that's called a steam turbine, basically a very fancy steam engine. It is 130 years old, and it still generates about 85% of all electricity worldwide. So the technology that powers almost all electricity in human civilization is from the era of Queen Victoria in England. So that's pretty incredible when you think about it.